Hello, CBSE class 12 physics, NCERT solutions from the chapter nuclei, exercise number 13.25 or 13.25. The question is this: a source contains two phosphorus radionuclides, 15 phosphorus 32 with a half-life of 14.3 days and 15 phosphorus 33 with a half-life of 25.3 days. Initially, 10% of the decays come from 15 phosphorus 33. How long one must wait until 90% to do so? So, there is a sample containing phosphorus 33 and phosphorus 32. The sample contains both phosphorus. Actually, it may contain more isotopes also, but for this sum, he says that the sample contains two phosphorus radionuclides. So, radionuclides, phosphorus 32 having a half-life of 14.3 days. For this half-life, 14.3 days, D, sometimes they indicate by the letter D, that means days. Phosphorus 33, he gives the half-life as 25.3 days, half-life, okay. See here, initially he says 10% of the decays come from phosphorus 31, 10% of the decays come from phosphorus 33. It is given initially. Okay. How long one must wait until 90% to do so? That means initially 10% of the total decay is from phosphorus 33. 10% of the total, meaning including phosphorus 32 also. So when you say that this is 10%, automatically this has to be 90%, meaning out of the total decay, 90% decays are from phosphorus 32 initially. Do you understand that? That means, let's say the total decay initially is say 10x, and out of that x decays are from phosphorus 33, 9x decays are from phosphorus 32. Total number of decays 10x. That means this is 1%, this is 10%, this is 90%. If you calculate, out of 10x it is x. For 10x, x. For 100, how much? 10x, it is x. For 100. So you will have 100 by 10, so 10%. This will be 90%. That means this is having 9x and this is x. So out of 10x radio decays, x should be from phosphorus 33. X decays from phosphorus 33, 9x decays should be from phosphorus 32. See, note that both the radio isotopes of phosphorus, they are beta minus emitter. This is also a beta minus emitter, this is also a beta minus emitter. So when this emits a beta minus, it will go into sulfur 33, this will go into sulfur 32. Okay, this usually we study in some other place, beta decay, how to write equation. For example, I'll explain this. 15 phosphorus 32 is a beta emitter, minus 1 beta 0 plus antineutrino. This will be 15, this one it has gone, so 16 sulfur 32 plus energy. So beta emitter. Similarly, you can write for phosphorus 33, not required for this sum. I just said that because this idea is important for 12th standard physics. Whatever comes along with the beta minus, you can even write minus 1 beta 0 or beta minus, both. Minus 1 beta 0 or beta minus. Anti-neutrino you have to write. And this sulfur is stable, 32. So leave this just a recollection. So coming to this problem. So the question asks you to find out how long you have to wait so that 90% of the total decay is from phosphorus 33. Let's say after a time t, the total number of nucleides decayed be 10y. The decayed nucleus, let's say 10y. You say 90% of this, so you call it as 9y and this is y. That means 90% of the total decays, 10y have decayed, out of the 10y, 9y should be from phosphorus 33 and y should be from phosphorus 32. That means 90% of the total decay is from phosphorus 33, 10% of the total decay is from phosphorus 32. How long you have to wait for such an event to take place? Understood this? Easy. Now, you can use the general equation n is equal to n0 e power minus lambda t. Applying this equation for this phosphorus 32, initially 9x, after time t y. So y is equal to, initially is this 9x, that is n naught e power minus lambda 1 into t. N is equal to n naught into e power minus lambda t. To start with, there were 9x, after time t it has come to y. Then applying it for phosphorus 33, 9y is equal to x e power minus lambda 2 into t. Lambda 1 is a decay constant for phosphorus 32, lambda 2 for phosphorus 33, decay constant. There is a formula relating decay constant and half life. Lambda is equal to 0.693 by t half. This also you should remember. That's a proof for everything, all these things. So after this, what you should do, you are supposed to find t. You are given lambda, you are given t half for this, t half for this phosphorus 32, t half for phosphorus 33 given. That means you can find lambda 1 and lambda 2. When you divide, you know y and x will go off. For example, I divide 1 by 2. What do I get? 1 by 9 is equal to 9 into e power. When you divide, this will be in the denominator, e power minus lambda 2 into t. So this will be e power lambda 2 into t minus lambda 1 into t. Okay, that is, I write here, 1 by 81 e power lambda 2t minus lambda 1t. Or you take the inverse, raising both left side and right side to power minus 1, just for convenience sake. Now this is 81, e power minus 1 is there, so e power lambda 1t minus lambda 2 into t. Taking logarithm 81 to the base e, take log to the base e, or natural logarithm. This will be lambda 1t minus lambda 2t, or t into lambda 1 minus lambda 2. Therefore, t is equal to ln 81, that means logarithm 81 to the base e, by lambda 1, which is 0.693 by 14.3 days, minus lambda 2, the decay constant of phosphorus 33. So 0.693 by t half for phosphorus 33, 25.3. The ln 81 you will have to take carefully. or 2.303 log 81 to the base 10. So what I do now, this can be log 81, can be 2.303 log 81. This is a common logarithm to the base 10. This is natural logarithm to the base e. If you know how to find out directly logarithm to the base e, you can use Clock's table and find out, or find logarithm to the base 10 multiplied by 2.303. I feel this is better. Therefore, t is equal to 2.303 log 81 to the base 10, 0.693 by 14.3 minus 0.693 by 25.3. Okay, so we'll simplify that. So t is equal to, I have to simplify this and check what answer we are getting. Okay, let me use my calculator. Okay, we're getting 208.59. So 209 days. Thank you.